Hey guys, welcome back to my channel WePlay. Today we are going to have a look at the overview of the latest patch coming to Tarkov, which is the 12.8. We will discuss what are the new and exciting things coming to the new patch. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started with the video. So in the new patch, they have added two new skills, which are crafting and hideout management. Both the skills will be regarding the hideout and upgrading the time required to complete a certain production in the hideout. Next is a new item, which is the compass. This new item will allow the players to easily identify directions and other PMCs by pressing the U key. This item will also be equipped in the new unlootable slot, which means no one will be able to take the compass. Next is the new type of bleeding, which is heavy bleeding, will be introduced, and it may open a lower chance than normal bleeding, and in order to stop it will require special treatment items to stop it successfully. The character with heavy bleeding leaves traces of blood on the surfaces, which will make it easier to locate a player who has encountered heavy bleeding. In order to fix the heavy bleeding, there are two ways to fix the bleeding, which are the S-March tourniquet and the hemostatic syringe. There is also a new beverage which has been introduced, which is the Kvass beverage, also shown in the podcast. Next, a new fast backpack dump is going to be introduced, where if the player is going to engage in a fight, he will quickly drop the backpack by double tapping the Z button or the button that is being assigned to it. New third version of the voice of Bear and the new voices of the bosses, which is the Gluhar, Sanitar and Rashala, is being introduced as well. In terms of weapons, they are going to bring the M45A1 pistol, KS-23 shotgun and the RFB rifle, with new weapon attachments to the guns as well. So there will be a new video about the attachments also. As the new equipments go, the clothes for the USEC and the bear, both the tops and lowers, are also coming. And the new armored vest, chest rig, backpacks, headphones, helmets and berets were also shown in the podcast. In this, they are going to bring a new feature in which we will see the group gathering screen in the lobby before going in raid, so we could see the other character models of the group members with their nicknames. Next, for the mods, weapons, items, move by the mouse drag and drop feature that will add a highlight to the weapon slots and the mod, and they will also fit in, so it will turn green if it is placed inside and yellow if it can be combined or installed. There will also be an option in game settings to change the selection of the body part colors from the inventory of the health tab from the old variation of only red monochrome. They have also added an ammo loading menu in the context menu of magazines in the stash, easier and will consume less time filling mags up. At the flea market, when you buy more items than are left on sale, the remaining available quantity will be bought instead of giving an error message. There will also be an automatic sorting of character stash for us lazy people, where all the containers, backpack, etc. will be sorted by a simple sort button. But the manual segregation or the manual Tetris is always preferred to do a better job. In the kill list after the raid, the field distance which will show the distance of the fatal shot will also be added. And next, when we exit the game, they have added a warning that the generator is on so that you don't forget and lose your valuable fuel. They have also added a hotkey to unload the chamber and reload the chamber directly. And if the weapon has no magazine and there is no cartridge, is now charged into the chamber if there is a bunch of rounds in the pocket or vest. Also, outside the raid, the stash can also be opened or closed by the hotkey which has been introduced, which is the tab key. In the optimization of the game, iteration of the animation system is being optimized. Also, the optimization of the AI of the server is being improved. There is also a new high quality color option which will be enabled by default, and we can disable it, which can also give us a small performance boost at the expense of image quality. AI improvements have also been added, and weapon swing in bot movements, improved phrases for the attack by scav bots has also been introduced. Raiders will now attack the scavs, which will make the reserve runs more interesting and valuable. There are a lot of changes in the update as well, where if the character is blind by flashbang, he will also reload with a mag drop. So the damage radius of the GL40 is now been decreased, and the PC blocks will now spawn SSDs and SCS drives. So keep an eye out for all the PC locations, as the SSD drives will be of value to make graphic cards in the hideout itself. In the questline of Tarkov shooter, players can now use any bolt action rifles, which will be a good way to upgrade and keep the bolt action snipers and experiment with it. Jaeger will also be unlocked after accepting of Gunsmith Part 1, where the previous requirement was Gunsmith Part 2. Reserve player spawn points are being reworked, and scav player spawn at the reserve location is made later in time, and also the trader's respawn timer is reduced to 2 hours instead of 3. Rest are the bug fixes of the game, which are a long list of desync fixes and bug fixes that were in the game previously. So I will not go through it all, but will leave a link in the description below so that you can all check it out for yourself. So that's it for the video. I hope I have covered all the important changes that are being introduced in the 12.8 update. I will also be making a breakup video about the 12.8 patch once it goes live on the server. If you have any questions regarding the patch notes or the changes, you can write it down in the comment section below. And if you like this video, please consider subscribing to the channel, as I will be coming up with new guide videos every week. And I will see you in the next one.